Hi, I'm Mike Holland, a member of Cellar Masters Home Winemaking Club in Los Angeles, and today I'm going to be disgorging some sparkling wine. Now, unfortunately, I don't have any videos of the other parts of the process, but this is the one that always seems to get the most attention and is the most dramatic. And this is the actual disgorging of the crown caps and getting the final corks and everything ready to go into final bottle. And so I've got a series of shots showing the different parts leading up to this, and so we'll get. So here are some of the tools we'll be using this afternoon to disgorge some of the bubbly. Now I can do this indoors, but for the sake of photographic integrity, we're going to shoot this outside today during daylight. So the first thing is going to be our bucket. Now this is what I'm going to actually be aiming the bottles into, and as you can see, I've already done some practicing already, so hopefully we'll have some good demonstration material for you. In addition to that, we have church key. Now there is the fancy decrowners that I cannot find anywhere to save my life, and I would dearly love to have one, but this actually works out pretty well. If a bidule sticks and needs a little bit of help being pulled out, sometimes a knife with a thin edge can get under there and help pry the sucker out. A partially filled mason jar filled with water just to get some of the salt off of the outside of the wine of the bubbly bottle when it comes out of the solution, and also makes it a little bit easier to clean the outside of the bottle. And it also can sometimes start loosening up the plug a little bit, so it might come out a little bit easier. Now this, of course, is the wire tool for the crown, and I wish I had a video on how to use one of these things. I have not been able to find one. If someone out there has one and can shoot a video and post it, you would be doing mankind a great service indeed. Then here are the wire crown, the wire cages that are going to go around the bottles and using the aforementioned wire tool. Of course, we have several rags with which to wipe things down. And yes, we are in Los Angeles, so get over it. These are our Belgian beer corks, which I discover work very, very nicely in champagne bottles. And then, of course, the corker itself, and there's been one modification. This is actually a drilled 7.5 stopper, and I've discovered that if you use this and turn the handle down to just about where the jaws meets the rubber, that still gives you enough room to pull the cork out of the bottle and also to pull it out of the corker itself, and you'll see that when we actually do the demo in a little bit. But there you have it. Oh, and just for the record, dog not necessary nor included, but you have to admit it does kind of give this that whole backyard homebrew thing. Now inside this refrigerator is where bottles getting ready to be disgorged are sitting in their inverted positions, and they are going to get nice and cold, and then they will get even colder once they are put into the salt water solution. Now this right here is a 5-gallon bucket with about 3 inches of water in it, and it is sitting in the freezer getting cold. There's about a pound of table salt in there, so that will lower the freezing temperature of the water below the point of freezing, which is what you want when you're going to be doing disgorging. Now I'm going to come back in here in a minute and check it with a probe thermometer and see if it has in fact gotten cold enough to add our bottles. Okay, so we'll drop the probe into the solution so we can see how cold it is. See it there? It is reading approximately 19 degrees, 17. There it is. There's the magic number. That's about as cold as it's gotten in here, and it works very, very well. So once the solution gets down to 17 degrees, now the bottles can be moved from that other refrigerator, lined up, point down, in this particular bucket in this fridge for anywhere from half an hour to an hour. I've timed it, and it seems to be about an hour is long enough. This is the moment of truth, the moment of glory, hopefully. Mm-hmm. And of course, just in case it isn't, I have my eye protection. And so what we're going to do is take one of our bottles that has been in the freezer, in the salt solution, and there is actually a plug of ice in here that you'd be able to, you can't see it on camera, but I can, holding it up to the light. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the bottle, I'm going to aim it at this container right here, so this is going to catch all of the junk and debris. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tip the bottle up to where the air bubble is right about there. That's basically at the base of the ice plug. I don't know if you can see it, but it's right about here. Should be here, but it's here in this case. So we'll see if we actually get a proper explosion or whether it's just, we'll see. So we got our cap ready to come off. There it goes. Okay, that one actually worked out pretty well. And so we are now down to this level of wine. And so now I'm going to take one of my beer corks. I'm going to put it in the opener. Look at it here. Now here's where I've got that stopper that is going to tell me exactly how far to push the plunger. So, one, two, three. So it's going to go down to right about there. So, now I'm going to take my wire handle, push this down so I can free the bottle. And see, well, the cork is slightly messed up, but it's still okay. It is sealed, that's the thing. Now the wire cage is going to go on top of here. And here's the trick. The wire needs to go underneath the lip right here so it will actually hold on. So having made sure that is lined up, as I said, if someone out there has a video showing you how to use this thing, I would love to see it. But I think what you do is you pull down to make sure the wire goes underneath the lip. Once you've done that, twist to create the knot. Tighten it two or three times. I don't know why they do five. I do three. This is good and tight right here. And it's ready to go into the box. Mm-hmm. So now I'm going to show you. I've got three more bottles in here. I'm going to show you what those three bottles look like in just the disgorging part. Maybe we've got a more dramatic disgorging shot to insert at this point.
All right, so I'm going to run around here.
All right. Now, this is to actually allow us to get some of the salt off of the bottle and also loosen the plug up a little bit. It's just regular water. And yes, as I said, we are in Dodger Town, and so just have to live with that. And judges. Plug here. So get a good shot of this. Mm-hmm. One, two, three. Put that on top. Maybe try a little bit of coaxing. There it goes. Right. Good. Next one. Let's see if we got a good disgorging shot.
I'm moving a little bit closer.
All right, good. Goes.
Oh, that went.
This one. This bunch, anyway. There we go. obviously some of them are more dramatic than others, but that's why you need something to shoot that crap into. I mean, if you were to see my my backyard out here, you'd see there's a bunch of caps and little bits and pieces left over from earlier practices. But anyway, again, this is one of those things that it's a mess, but I think it's worthwhile once these things are labeled and stored in about 6 months from now. This is June, so hopefully by Christmas or New Year's Eve, we'll be able to start popping open bubbly and drinking that and enjoying that and celebrating with it all the time, because it's not just for holidays. Anyway, there are any number of ways to do these sorts of things, but again, this is how I do it. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.